A very good morning to the all the teachers of Rajanna Silsila and welcome to the second day of training on enhancing online day one of the training, and we hope so we'll see more participation on the day two also. So moving forward, Neetu, so Guruchala is an initiative of Indus Tower Limited and Vodafone Idea Foundation, where the content partner is Jigyasa and implemented by Pratham Education Foundation. So today in this last day of training, my co-presenter Neetu will be also there with us. So Neetu, moving forward, if you want to share some important things which should be kept in mind during the training.
Right, Shubham. Once again, a very warm welcome to all the teachers and thank you for joining us for this day two session. And as we had discussed yesterday also, there are certain points and which can be kept in mind while attending the training. And as we can see that a lot of new teachers have also joined us for today's session. So we would just like to share these points once again with our teachers so that we all can get the maximum benefit out of this training. So, teachers, there are certain points which we can keep in mind while attending this training. The first point is that we can keep a notepad and pen with ourselves, and we can make notes of ideas and questions which we are sharing here. If you have any questions, you can also note down these questions. And after noting down these questions, you can
down
ask
these questions
you
in
can ask
our
these questions
comment
in our,
section.
You can type your
comment
questions,
section,
you can
answers,
type your
or any
questions,
ideas
answers,
which you want
or
to
any ideas which you want to share with other teachers in the chat box. And we'll be very glad to bring these ideas and suggestions on our screen. So please keep sharing your ideas and questions in the chat section. One more point which can be kept in mind is that do sign up on Guruchala for more updates, because we'll be conducting more such workshops and trainings and competitions in the upcoming time. So you can easily sign up on the Guruchala with your Gmail ID or maybe with your Facebook ID or with your mobile number. We'll be sharing this again, that how you can basically sign up on Guruchala. So please stay tuned to know more about Guruchala and how you can log into Guruchala and access different features of Guruchala. And if I talk about day two's training agenda, that what we are going to discuss in today's session. So the first thing we are going to talk about is planning for content creation. As Shubham, a lot of teachers were asking us about that how they can create digital content for their students, because this is the time when our teachers have learned about technical skills and they want to share a lot of content with their students, customized content basically, which can enhance the understanding of the students. So we'll be talking about that, how our teachers can plan for content creation. We'll also be sharing a strategy which can be implemented and used while creating content, which is hook to action strategy. We'll be discussing this in detail, that what is hook to action strategy and how our teachers can utilize this strategy. We will also talk about that, how we can create digital content using Microsoft PowerPoint. I think PowerPoint is a software which our teachers have been using from a long time, and we can certainly discuss about it, that how this PowerPoint can be make more effective for our students, and we can create digital content out of it. We will also talk about that, how we can convert PowerPoint into interactive videos. So we will just not stick to the PowerPoint presentation, but we will also talk about how these simple presentations can be made into interactive videos. We will also talk about Guruchala's course module, that how Guruchala's course modules can help our teachers and help them in developing their skills. These are not only 21st century skills, but also our content creation skills. And apart from that, a lot of information is there, which we try to provide through our course module. So we will talk in detail that how our teachers can enroll in these course modules and complete these modules. So this is the broad agenda which we'll be talking about in today's session. And if we move ahead, we would also like to mention once again that at the end of today's session, we'll be sharing a Google form with all the teachers, and all the participants who will be submitting this form will receive a certificate of participation on their email ID. So teachers, please stay connected till the end of the session so that you can get the Google form and submit it to get your certificate. So Shubham, this was a broad idea what we are going to talk about today in today's session. So now I would like to ask you that, apart from the information sharing, what else are we going to do in today's session?
Yeah, Neetu. So we have lined up various interactive activities and fun activities with our teachers. The first activity will be guess the answer. We'll be having fastest finger first, and also audience poll. I hope like the teachers will enjoy these activities and will having too much conversation with our teachers. And moving forward, Nitu, let's have our first activity with our teachers. So teachers, the question is, can you solve these three quizzes within 60 seconds? So there will be a timer of 60 seconds and we'll be presenting the questions right now. So the first question, is, which is the largest district area? So then the second question is, where is the lowest natural point on Earth? The second question is, where is the lowest natural point on Earth? And the third is, in which year did the Jallianwala tragedy took place? So these are the three questions. I will request to all the teachers to participate and write their answer in the comment section. You can see the at the right hand side the comment section. I would request every teachers to write their answer, and the timer has been started.
Right, Shubham. I'm sure the teachers who had joined us in yesterday's session, they are familiar with the format we have, that that we keep conducting such activities so that teachers can also share their answers with us. And Shubham, what do you think about the answers? Do you think these questions are difficult for our teachers, or they'll be able to answer it quickly? Because I can see there are some answers which are there in the chat section, and teachers have already started responding.
So I guess I think a few of the questions are tough to answer, but still I think teachers are giving an attempt, and most of them are like giving the answer Mahbooba Nagar, and some sir has written it's okay. I think Rama Devi ma'am has written the answer for the Jallianwala tragedy. She is saying it happened on 1919. Hariprasad sir was talking, it's in 1913 it happened, the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy. I think the answer are coming in pieces. Yeah.
Right. So with this, our time has also gone up. Our timer has gone up. And now I think this is the time where we can show the correct answers to our teachers. So teachers, here are the correct answers. So The largest district in area wise in Telangana is Bhadradri, and the lowest natural point on Earth is Mariana Trench. And in which year did the Jallianwala tragedy took place? It was in 1919. So Shubham, a lot of teacher had already answered it, and they have correctly answered it. So congratulations to all the teachers for giving correct answers, and thank you so much to other teachers for participating in activity, and we hope we'll see this kind of participation in the upcoming session as well.
So moving forward, we had too much discussion on the day one on various topics, on various frameworks we have shared. So Nitu, can you just have a recall on whatever we have discussed on the day one?
Right, Shubham. So on the day one, we had a discussion about the 21st century skills, that what are the 21st century skills that our teachers need. And also, once we have these skills, we need to transfer these skills into our students as well, because then only we'll be able to teach them that how they can compete in this 21st century. So there were these six skills which we had discussed in yesterday's session. The first skill is communication. Second skill is collaboration. Third is creativity. Fourth is critical thinking. And collectively, these four skills are also known as four C's of 21st century, which is communication, collaboration, critical thinking, and creativity. Apart from that, we also talked about the technical capability, because as we know that a lot of things are happening around, a lot of things are getting updated around us. So we also need to remain technically updated so that we can basically get the maximum benefit from the technology which is developing day by day. So this was also a skill which we talked about. And apart from that, we also had a discussion on the social skills, that as we know that we all are living in a society. On a daily basis, we interact with a lot of people. So we need to have certain amount of social skills so that we can connect with others easily, and we can basically support them and get support from them to conduct our activity, day-to-day activities. And if we talk about specifically about teaching learning process, we need a lot of support from the parents, from our fellow colleagues, and from students as well. So in such a situation, we also need to have an ample amount of social skills in ourselves. So this was about 21st century skills, which we had discussed in yesterday's session. And apart from that, Shubham, we also talked about that how our teachers need to plan their online classes. For planning your online classes, you need to know about that what kind of learning environment is there at your students' home. Because once we are aware about the resources they have, the kind of support they are getting from parents, then only we'll be able to plan certain strategies and we'll be able to monitor them as well. So we also shared this example with our teachers that this kind of a checklist can be used, and our teachers can obviously make changes to this checklist if they want to, depending upon the situation of their students are facing and the kind of environment they are getting at home. So this check, we also shared this checklist and some strategies with our teachers that what kind of strategies can be implemented if they are taking any kind of online classes, and if they are taking any kind of offline classes, if they are able to connect with the students offline. So what kind of strategies can be there, what kind of activities can be there, which can be implemented with the students. So these were the two topics which we covered in yesterday's session. We talked about skills and we talked about online classes, how they can basically use certain strategies to for their online classes. So this was about yesterday's session, Shubham. And now, as we know that our teachers also wanted to know about the content creation part. They wanted to know how they can create digital content for the students. So Shubham, if we can start with a question here, because we know that our teachers in the last 1 year have already created a lot of content. They basically learned about the technology, they learned about the new technical skills, and they have tried to create a lot of content for the students. So before we move on forward and we talk about content creation, we want to know from our teachers through this fastest finger first activity that teachers, please share that what type of digital content have you created for your students. It could be in any format, whatever digital content you have created in the last 1 year, you can share that what kind of content did you create for your students. And as all our activities has a timer of 1 minute, so we'll just start with our timer, Shubham, and let's see what type of content our teachers have already created for their students.
Yeah, Neetu. So I would request to all the teachers to answer. I think the answers are already started. One of the sir have shared they use Zoom classes. I would request all other teacher also to write their answer in the comment section, like which type of digital content they have created. I think Kiran sir is saying they have created video lessons. Ganesh sir is saying it is YouTube, and sir is saying Google Form. So I guess there is a diversity of digital content teachers have created.
Right, Shubham. We can also see that a lot of teachers are sharing. Dasari sir has shared that he has recorded some videos for the students. Rajaji sir is sharing that he has shared a quiz and multiple questions. And also we can see a lot of teachers are sharing about YouTube videos. And yes, Shubham.
So I think a lot of answer have come from teachers, and we know like there is a diversity, and teachers are they know like how to create the contents in within this 1 year. They have honed their digital skills. So just to like give a glimpse, and moving forward, we would be like more focusing on these planning to create content. So if we move forward, Neetu, the first thing, like if we talk about the planning to create contents, we should first talk about the things to keep in mind before starting to create a content. So the things to keep in mind while planning will be, the first thing will be the what to teach. So whenever like we start with a lesson or in the physical classroom also, so first of all we decide that what to teach. So we should be clear about the chapter and topic and identify the objective, like the what will be the learning objective. If I taught this lesson to the students, what will be the learning objective, what is the learning outcome of this lesson. So after we have decided what to teach, then the next will be how to teach. So as this is a online classroom, we can plan few activities and questions for these sessions. we can have a quiz during the online lecture, or we some of the teachers are sharing, they have used Google Forms, so we can share a Google Form with the students. And we should include the points to ponder, like the key facts from the textbook. We can have activity on the conclusion part for the revision part. So now we have decided what to teach and how to teach. Then the final one will be how to present. So this is the main challenge which most of them face, is how to present, like what kind of medium the teacher should be using. So the teaching medium should be, it's depend on what type of content they want to show. So the planning for planning the medium of the delivery. The second will be the platform for the content creation. So there are like many tools. For example, teachers can use online tools like Canva. They can use like offline tools like PPT. So there are a few tools. So how they will be creating content there, that we'll be discussing later during this training only, and decide the type of digital content to use. So all of these we'll be discussing, and these are the three main points. Neetu, after like the teacher have decided all these points, what to teach, and they have decided how they will be creating content, what will be the medium and what will be the tools. So is there any strategy we can share with our teachers, like how to go with the content creation process?
Right, Shivam. As you have already discussed, that the planning forms the base of anything, and planning is important when we are even taking our classes or when we are creating any kind of content, because there are certain expectations from our content type which we are creating. So it is important to plan in advance that what kind of content do we want to create, and what do we want to exactly teach through that content piece, and how we are going to teach it. And then the important part comes up, that how we are going to line up this content or how we are going to present it. So once we have planned all the basic things of the content creation, then we can move on to our strategy, and we can talk about the strategy, that what strategy can be used for the content creation, and what kind of format we can use while we are trying to create content. So if I talk about the strategy which we can use is hook to action strategy. As we can know from the name only, that hook to action is basically a strategy where we can have the attention of the student, where we can hook their attention at the start of the content only, and then after that, once we have their attention and once they are engaged in the content, then we can provide the further explanation of the content. So if I talk about step by step, that what are the steps of the hook to action strategy, so we can first start with the hook, that whatever content we are creating, if we are creating a video, we can start our video with an introduction or opening of a lesson that grabs the student's attention. A lot of examples could be used at the start of the video. You can use daily life situations, or maybe you can use some trivia questions to basically get the attention of the students right at the start of your topic. So in case if you are keeping a video, this can be used. In case a lot of our teachers also, they create PowerPoint presentation. Even if you are creating a PowerPoint presentation, at the start of the presentation, you can keep some kind of activities or some kind of examples which helps you to get the attention of the students. So the first step in order to create or present your content, you can use the first thing is hook. The first step is hook to basically get the attention of the students. Then if I talk about the next point, which is concept. Obviously, we are creating content to explain the concept to the students and to give them more information about the students. So the second step we need to keep in mind is concept. So we can explain the concept in interesting ways using resources. There could be a lot of resources you can use, videos or maybe PowerPoint presentations or any kind of quizzes if you want to keep in between to have a discussion with the students. So all these aspects can be covered in our concept part when we are trying to explain this to the students. The third step which can be used, which needs to be used here, is trigger. That we should include such kind of content which can basically spark deeper thoughts on the concept. We need to keep certain elements in our content which gives a trigger to the student's mind, and he or she wants to learn and know more about the concept through this trigger point. So we need to basically keep such kind of content in between our basically in between our content piece or maybe in between our lectures, so that the students get a trigger point and they ponder upon the concept more. Now the fourth step is repeat. Obviously, once we have taught the concept, we have provided the trigger questions to the students, we also need to keep repeating the concept, because as we know that students need that space and time to process the information, whatever they have learned till now. So we can basically try to repeat and reinforce core concept which we have taught in the classroom. So the repeat is the fourth step of our hook to action strategy. And now the last step is action. So we can conclude our content piece with a task or maybe with a summary and with some real life examples where the students get an opportunity to implement or apply the knowledge they have learned in the concept. So these are the five steps of hook to action strategy, Shubham: hook, concept, trigger, repeat, and action. So these are the five steps which we can keep in mind while we are creating any kind of digital content. It could be an infographic, it could be a video, it could be a slide show, a presentation. Whatever type of content we are creating, we can always try to embed these five steps into our content piece. If we are creating a video, at the end of the video, we can ask the students to do a project, or maybe we can leave them with a few questions so that they go back and explore the concept more. So this kind of a thing can be done while we are creating any kind of online content for our students. So Shubham, once we have discussed about this hook to action strategy, could you please share with our teacher that what kind of content can we specifically keep in each section of our hook to action strategy?
Yeah, Neetu. So before going with the which type of content which can be used in this hook to action in every step, let's have an activity, guess the answer with our teachers. So teacher, let's participate in this activity, and the question is, which of the following word does not belong in the group? So we have a 1 minute timer, and I would request to all the teachers to participate and write their answer in the comment section. So what is the word which doesn't belong to the group? You can see there are five words below. So I think the teacher should answer. You should have to find the odd one out of these five words. And the timer has already been started.
Yeah. Right, Shubham. I think teachers are taking some time to basically see all the words and analyze that which word could be odd one out, because all the words are looking very similar. So let's see what our teachers are saying. So I can see a few answers are coming. Dasari sir has said that quotes is the odd one out. It is correct. He's saying that this is the answer. And there are other teachers. Jakarnichi has shared that poster is the answer. So yeah, we can see a lot of teachers are already sharing their answers.
Yeah, I think most of them are saying it's quotes. So the timer is about to end, and the timer is ended. Let's see, Neetu, what is the answer for this activity?
Right. So the correct answer is quotes. As we can see that all the other words, they are basically the anagrams of each other. But this is one word which is different from the other words. And we can see that corset, escort, they have similar alphabets. They have same alphabets. And quotes is one word which is different from the other words. So yeah, thank you teachers for your active participation in the activity.
Yeah, congratulations for the right answer, teachers. Let's move forward and know about what kind of content pieces which can be used in every step of hook to action strategy. So first of all is the hook, where we want to attract the attention of the student. So during the first class or first presentation, the teacher could use a trivia or a fun fact about the lesson. They can use a daily life example or real life example. They can give a reference to an event or a story. They can start a lesson with a story. So this kind of content pieces can be used in the hook step. Then after, in the concept, for the concept step, you can use the regular mode like concept videos. You can use simulations, concept slideshow, or a piece of information from the textbook. You can take a picture from the textbook and use in your virtual teaching. So for the concept, this kind of content pieces can be used. So after hook concept, for the trigger, For triggering questions, you can have a question like from the textbook, or have a you can ask the student to share a perspective, like what they think about the concept. You can seek a reaction on a situation. You can ask the to students, like give a reaction like about this concept or the lesson learnt. After asking the triggering question, the teacher can add a repeat part. In the repeat stage, teacher have to revise the concept once again. So for that, you can use the slide, so like concept slide once again to revise the concept, or can give a example or share a case study. Case study, most of them time it works, because in a case study the student have to implement practically, and at the end of the action part, in the action stage, you can ask questions like regular question like MCQs. They can have long answer type, or they can ask a task to do. So these are kind of content, video content can be used in this Huksu action strategy. So Neetu, now we have discussed like various content type which can be used in the hook to action strategy. Can we like move forward and let's show our teachers how to create a PPT, like use the Microsoft PowerPoint, and using this hook to action strategy we can made a interactive PPT out of it.
Right, Shivam. So as you have mentioned about that, a lot of types of content are available, and they are also available on Guruśāla. So if our teacher wants to directly access to this content, they can visit Guruśāla. And in case if they want to create their own content, a lot of strategies are available for that also. So our teachers can visit Guruśāla and see that what kind of resources are there, and what kind of basically type of content they can create for the students, and different type of content they, which will help them to implement this hook to action strategy while creating any kind of content. So as you have mentioned about the PowerPoint presentation here, firstly we can show a case study to our teachers, and then we can discuss it in detail that what kind of case study is this and how our teachers can create such case studies for their students also. So I would just like to present my screen here, and this is the kind of case study our teachers can create, Shubham. So this is one case study which basically talks about Sivi's adventure in the jungle. This case study basically comprises of the science chapter, which is for class 8, conservation of plants and animals. So we can see that two characters are here, Sivi and Uncle Jagan. So let's see what they are going to talk about and how they are basically trying to teach about this concept to our students. So this case study is used for class 8, and now we can say that this second slide talks about that it is vacation time again, and this time Sivi is very excited as her parents are taking her to meet her adventurous Uncle Jagan, who works in Ranthambore National Park. So a reference of Ranthambore National Park is taken here, and we can see that Sivi is very excited to visit this Ranthambore National Park, and this could be our storyline. Whenever we are teaching a concept to our students, we can keep a storyline so that the student feel connected to it, because we all have our relatives in different states who are living there, and there are times when in our vacation when we visit them, and we try to basically know about their city, we try to know about what kind of situation they have in their areas. So a similar storyline could be added here so that the students feels connected to the concept. So we can see that here a reference of Ranthambore National Park is taken. So now we can see that what else Sivi is going to see in this national park. So here we can see that a question is given, a question is there for the student, that Sivi wants to know that, can you tell me the name of the state in which Ranthambore National Park is situated? So we can see that at the start, a reference is given there, a storyline is formatted, and after this storyline, there are a few questions. Basically, we are trying to provide trigger to the student so that the student think about it. And we can see as we are visiting the forest, we saw a herd of elephant. Then we can see that there is next slide in which uncle is asking that, can you tell me the four reasons why do we have these national parks, and why do we keep these national parks? So such questions can be provided to the students so that they keep thinking about the concept. While learning the concept, they are also thinking more about it, and they are trying to further explore these concepts here. So now we can see that in the next slide there are a few more questions, and some information is also there. So do you know in India 63 football fields worth of forest land fell prey to development activities every day between 2014 and 2017? So apart from asking question, there is a lot of information which is being provided to the students. Now if we go forward, we can see there is lot of information available, and in the first so we can see that this presentation is basically divided in two parts. So now when we are talking about the first part, we can see that a lot of question information is provided to the students, and here we can see there are four questions which are given to the students so that they can think about the concept, they can basically try to explore the concept more. So once this part is over, once we have provided a level of information to the students and we have also asked some questions from them, then what we can do that in the second half, we can basically try to provide the information to the students that whether the questions they have answered are correct or not. So here we can see that finally CV is back to school, and but CV was very excited to share all her adventures with her friends in the school and tell them more about the jungle. So let's see what CV is talking about and how she is giving answers to the students. So here we can see that the subject and topic and all the information is there, and now we can see the case study answers. So here we can see that the first question was, can you tell me the name of the state in which Ranthambore National Park was situated? So here a brief detail about is provided. So like this, we can see all the questions have been answered here. So basically this case study, Shubham, is divided into two parts, where in the first part we are trying to provide the information and ask questions, and in the second part we are trying to give the answers to the students. So in the current situation, when we are trying to connect with the students online and we are teaching them online, such kind of presentation can help us. We can share the first half of the presentation with the students in 1 week, and maybe in the second week or in the second class, whenever we are connecting with the students second time, then we can share the other half of the case study, and students will be able to match their answers. They'll be able to see that whether they have the apt amount of information about the topic or not, and what else they can learn. So this will help them to revise the concept as well, and they will get the correct answers also. So in such a format, we can basically share our case study with the students. Yes, Shubham.
Yeah, Neetu. So I think it's a great presentation, and I guess this is made on Microsoft PowerPoint only, and I would request teachers also to give a try, and I think most of the teachers have made in the past also PPT content, but I would guess this is they can take a reference from this PPT also to how to put all this content, how to put a lesson into a PPT format. So I would request all the teachers to keep asking questions and share ideas on the chat so that we'll be answering your queries. And so moving forward, Neetu, I have seen there were various elements in this PPT. So let's go one by one, what were the elements? So before going to the elements, can we just show the first element would be this is the hook concept. You have showed that there is a characters, we have two characters, there is a character CV, there is Uncle Jagan. So for the hook concept, it's a best example. We can use characters for the hook to grab the attention of students. After that, I have also seen that there were triggering question where CV was asking question on where is the Ranthambore National Park, and I can see in that picture also on that map that this park was situated, this biodiversity park was situated in Rajasthan. So this type of content type can be created in PPT. As well as I can see that in the repeat section there were few questions were asked. So before seeing these elements, can we show our teachers how to create this PPT, Neetu?
Right, Shubham. So here we can see that the different elements which were used in the PowerPoint presentation were like this. That we could see that the hook section was there because because an attractive name was given to the presentation. We were talking about Sivi's adventure in the jungle, and I'm sure the students will be able to connect with it more because they would be eager to know about what we are going to talk in the PowerPoint presentation. So this kind of an attractive title could be given to our any kind of presentation or case study we are keeping. After that, we have seen that a trigger point is there, which you have already shared. And then we have also tried to provide the repeat section where basically the students get an opportunity to revisit the concept and learn more about it. So now, since you are talking about the elements of creating a presentation, so we can just show our teacher that what kind of elements are there. So majorly, two types of elements could be there that we can basically identify the content resource type, that what type of content do we want to create, whether we want to create a concept slideshow or whether we want to create a case study or we want to provide any kind of practice questions for the students or challenge questions. So there could be different formats for our PowerPoint presentation. It's not necessary that we always create a case study. We can create different kind of content out of our PowerPoint presentation. And then we can also identify some elements of hook to action strategy. So it's not important, it's not compulsory that you add all the five elements of hook to action strategy in your presentation. There could be chances that you want to create maybe two or three elements of hook to action strategy in one type of content, and then other remaining type of remaining steps into some other kind of content. So here majorly we can see that in this kind of a case study, there were three elements which we have just discussed, that hook, trigger and repeat was there. So similarly, you can add stories, situation, trivia, video questions for your students, and accordingly you can finalize your presentation and share with your students. So yes, Shubham, these were some elements.
We have seen in this PPT also, the sample PPT you are showing, like how like three elements we have focused on any three of this strategy. Like we have used the characters, we have used the triggering question, and we also have given some follow-up question to our students. And after, like if the teachers have identified what type of content resource they will be providing, and then they have a brief description, like they have a brief meaning about the hook to action strategy. So how to like amalgamate, how to combine these two ideas of content creation and this hook to action strategy and make a PPT. So Neetu, can you show like how to create all of this thing in a PPT, in a Microsoft PPT, to our teachers, so that our teachers will get a idea, like if they after this training, if they give a try, like to put their lesson into a PPT and share with their students.
Right, Shubham. So I hope my screen is visible to everyone.
Yeah, Neetu.
Yes. So if I take a blank slide, if I start creating my PowerPoint presentation, I'm sure our teachers must be aware of the basic functions and basic tools we have here in the PowerPoint presentation, because our teachers have already been creating a lot of content for their students. So we can see that there is an option of file, home, insert, design, transitions, animation, slideshow, review, view. So these are the basic tools we have to create any kind of PowerPoint presentation. So we can see that on the home page we have options for creating new slides, we have option for pasting anything if you want to change any kind of layout, reset or section. And apart from that, the other sections opens up when you start working. So we can see that some of the options are highlighted at the start, but some of the options are faded here. So once we start working on it, once we start adding elements to it, the other options will also appear on the screen. Yes, Shubham.
Like after like starting with the PPT, can we give a general description about the tabs and like how the tabs will, what are the basic function of all these tabs, and how to go with the, like I have seen there are very good background pictures and characters. So let's start one by one with the general settings, and then you can show like how to create all these characters, the background, and start with the PPT creation. Yeah, Neetu.
Right, Shubham. So once we have seen the home section, a lot of options are there. When I move on to other section, there is insert section. From here, you can insert new slides. You can also insert any kind of table. Like we had seen that in our case study in the second part, there were a lot of question and answers there. And a table was also inserted there when we were trying to differentiate between between national parks and zoo. So we could see that a lot of tables and other things were added into our slideshow. So we can insert things from here. We can insert table. We can insert pictures from here. Also, if you want to add any kind of shapes, that option is also available with us. We want to comment or we want to add any text or maybe header or any kind of word art, you will get all the options here. Even we can also insert videos and audios here. So Shubham, this option is also available if we have seen any video on YouTube, or maybe if we have any video in our desktop. So we can always insert these videos in our presentation as well. Then the next option is there. If you want to change the layout and design of the slides, we can change it from here. A lot of options are available. You can also click on the drop down and you will get more options here. So you can change color fonts, effects from here. You can also change your slide size and you can format background from here. Then after that, we have transitions options. If you want to keep any kind of transitions into your slideshow, that can also be done. If you want to keep any kind of animation, that option is available here on the top bar. You will also get option of slideshow. How do you want to present your slide? If you want to record your slide. So all these options are there. If you want to change the basic layout of your slide, that can be done from here. You can see that after completing your presentation, you can also review it. You can check the basic spellings and other things from directly here. If you want to translate or language change, that can also be done. If you want to change the basic layout, then slide master option is there. You will be able to change any kind, you will be able to make any kind of changes to the basic layout of template as well. So Shubham, basically, if we talk briefly, so these all options are available for us, which can be utilized while we are trying to make our presentation more interactive for the students.
Yeah, Neetu. So like you have given a good description about all the tabs. So starting with the PPT, if you see the sample PPT we have shown to our teachers, it was very colorful. It has a good background. So can you start the teacher would go with what would be the first step to make a very interactive PPT? So yeah, Neetu.
Right, Shubham. So we could see that there in that slideshow, we were trying to teach about the jungle. Right, we were talking about the conservation of plants and animals. So for that, we had kept a background which was about the forest, which was basically which had the view of the forest. So for example, if I want to teach water cycle to my students now, so I want to create a separate presentation and want to teach water cycle. So what I can do is I can right click on the slide, and once I right click on the slide, I will get this option of format background. I hope my screen is visible.
Neetu, the screen is visible.
Right. So if we click on the format background here, so then a pop-up will open. You can see that there are a lot of options for the format background. You can solid fill, you can gradient fill, you can picture or texture pattern, whatever you want to insert here. So you can do that. Now, since we want to keep an interactive background, so what we can do, we can insert some kind of picture here. So I'll click on this option of picture. Once I have clicked on this option, you can see that there is option of picture resource. So you can click on the insert section of picture resource. And if I try to insert, you can see that it will give me option that whether I want to insert from a file or I want to search for any kind of online pictures or whether I want to add any kind of icon here. So for now, I'll search online and I'll go online basically to look for an appropriate image which will help me to support my teaching resource and talk about water cycle. Here I'll take an example of Riverside. I'll try to get an image of Riverside. So you can see that a lot of images will appear in front of me, and whatever image looks appropriate to me, I can choose that image. So I can, if I want to look for animated image, I can put that Riverside animated image or maybe a Riverside clip art. But if I want to take an actual image, so I can just simply put Riverside, and you can see a lot of options are there. And then I'll select the this option. I'll select the first option here, and I'll click on insert. And then you can see my background of the presentation is ready. So here I have an image where I can see water and I can see mountains are there. So this could be an appropriate background if I want to teach water cycle to my students. So like this, our teachers can add background to their images. And if you want to apply this same background to all our present, all our slides, so what we can do, Shubham, we can click on apply to all. I can insert multiple slides here, and then I can click on this option of apply to all, and the same background will be applied to all my slideshow. But if I want to keep changing this background depending upon the topic I'm covering in my water cycle concept, I can keep changing it as well. So that totally depends on me, that how many slides do I want to keep this background. So like this, I can insert the background here. Yes, Shubham.
So like I can see it's a very good background you have used. So like if you see the sample PPT we have shown, there were the first it was about a topic. So how to like the teacher could add a interactive topic so it would be more visible to the students, and after that we can go with the characters, Neetu.
Right, Shubham. So if I want to give an attractive headline to my my concept, so what I can do, I can go to insert, I can choose a shape. You can see that option of shapes is here. I can choose any shape whichever I like. So for now I'll choose a banner. So you can say that I can basically then insert this banner on the top of my presentation. If I want to change color, I can always go for that. I can change any kind of color which basically will support the background also and which looks attractive to the student. So I can choose any color whichever I feel will basically go with my background. So I can here insert that shape, and after that you can start typing. You can just double click on the shape and then you can start typing whatever you want to type. So for now I'll just keep water cycle. Or maybe I can keep that, how do we get trained? So like this, I can basically add my topic here. And maybe if I don't want to keep water cycle, that can also be done. I will just try to make it more attractive so that students will be eager to know that what more I'm going to teach in the concept. Then after doing this, what we can do, we can obviously we can go to the home option. We can increase the size. If you want to change the color, that option is also available. We can change color, whatever goes with my background. I can always change to that color. If I want to keep it blue, like I'll be talking about water cycle, so I can do that. If I want to change the kind of look it has, so I can also change that. You can go to fonts and you can change the theme also. So here, like this, I can add my add any kind of shape. I can insert any kind of shape here, and then I can add my topic here. So yes, Shubham.
Yeah, Neetu. So I think just before going to forward, some of the teachers are asking, like, we are using online pictures, so does it have a copyright issue? But I would say that there will be no copyright issue, because when we are adding the picture, if we show once again, if we show example, there is an option of creative art. So when that option is there, so all the pictures we are adding here are from Wikipedia, which are open source and free of cost. So everyone can use. There will be no copyright issue. But if you are using any other picture from any other website, then there will be a copyright issue. So for now, there is no issue of copyright. And yeah, Neetu, so like we have added a very good banner to explain the topic, what is the topic. So how to go with the characters? Like I have seen a few characters you have used to use, like it was very animated PPT. So how can the teacher add those characters into their presentation?
Right, Shubham. So once we have basically created a basic layout. So after that, we can keep inserting other things in our presentation to make it more attractive. So like if I want to add a character, that series character was there in the last presentation. If I want to add any other character here, so I can go to insert section again. I can click on the pictures. And then if I already have any picture, I can basically upload it from this device. Or if I want to search image online, I can go to online pictures. And like you had already mentioned about there is a thing Creative Commons license. So if our teachers want to search any kind of images, they can go to this option and they will get all the free images there. So if I want to basically search a character here, I want a character of a girl. So I can type here girl and then I can type clip art. So I'll get all the animated. Here, teachers, you can see that Creative Commons only. That means all these images are basically created for the reuse purpose. You can easily insert any kind of images from here and these images will not have any copyright issue. So this can be done from here. So now if I move forward and I select any character which I think my students will be able to connect and which will be apt for my presentation. So I'll just select the character and I'll insert character in my presentation. So when I click on insert, you will see that the image will start getting inserted here. So then this image is here. I can basically resize it. Teachers, please try to resize this from the corner. Because if you will resize it from anywhere else, so the image will get stretched. So it is a suggestion that you basically try to resize the image from corners. You just drag it from corner and then you can resize it. So I can see this is my character here. So once I have inserted my character, obviously I need this character to interact with my audience, with my students. So then what I can do, I can add some dialogues which my character will say. So for this, Shubham, we can again go to insert section. We can select a shape, basically a shape for a dialogue. So I can see that at the last, we have this option of callouts. So different type of callouts are there. So whatever is convenient for me, I can select that callout and I can draw it here. So once I have basically drawn it here, then I can add the dialogue of my character here. So let's say we have already interacted with Siri once. Let's say this is a new character and she's giving her introduction. Hi, I am Millie. So Millie is talking, now Millie is going to talk to us about the water cycle and she will help us to understand this concept better. So like this, Shubham, I can add my character here and then I can add the dialogue of the character.
So yeah, yes. It's look quite interactive, like in the sample PPT also we have shown, and here also a teacher can create, add characters, add banners to it and also use dialogue for here. So if we like the teachers wanted to know that what more we can add to this PPT to make it more interactive, as well as like if we show our teachers if they want to add any animation, and so like in their virtual teaching, they can show that animation to their students also.
Right, Shubham. So for adding animation, we can go to the option of animation and we can see for now all the options are faded because we have not selected that what part do we want to animate or what element of the PowerPoint do we want to animate. So what we can do now, that if I want my banner to be animated, I want this topic, the shape to be animated. So what I can do, I can select the shape. After selecting the shape, you can go to animations. And you can select the type of animation you want to keep here. So if you want it to appear on the screen with a click, so you can select appear if you want it to be to fly in on the screen. So I'll just show you that how it will appear on the screen if I choose the fly in option. So this is how it is going to appear on screen. So for now, I'll just choose the fly in option and like this, my option will appear here. And once my topic is there, I want the character to appear on the screen. So for the second animation, I can choose my character and then I can choose the type of animation I want to keep for my character here. So I can keep appear, that the character will appear on the screen. So this is my second animation. And now if I want to animate her dialogue as well, that once the character is on the screen, after that, her dialogue should appear on the screen. So I can select the text box. And similarly, I can choose a fly-in option. So this is how her dialogue will appear on the screen. So Shubham, we can also see that there are some numbers appearing on the screen. We can see that on the banner, number one is written there. On the character, number two is written there. And on the dialogue box, number three is written there. So this is the sequence of my animation. So whenever I'll click one by one, my animations will keep appearing on the screen. So for this, we can also see that if our teacher wants to change it, if our teacher wants to shift basically this animation, so they can go to this option of animation pane. They can click on the animation pane and here we can see that 1, 2, 3 options are there. If I want to shift any kind of animation, if I want my character should come later and the dialogue should appear first. So what I can do, I can just simply choose this part and I can drag it upward or I can just drag it down. So like this, I can also change the sequence of my animation. So this is how I can, if I have already put the animation on all the characters and all the dialogue boxes. So after that, I can see if I want to change it, then this simple option is available. You can just go to animation pane and you can shift your animations, and you can change the sequence accordingly. So this was one part, Shubham. And after putting animation, if you want that your animation should appear on click, then you can see here is the option for that. Start on click, so you will get this animation. If you want that your animation should appear on the screen, you do not want to keep it on click, then you can change it. You can keep it with previous or after previous. So that sequence, the sequence you have kept, the content will keep appearing accordingly. If you want to keep any kind of time duration to it, that if you want that the first thing should come and then after 20 second or 30 second the other animation or the other part should come on the screen, you can also set the timer as well. So with this basic information of animation, we can create a very interactive presentation for our students, Shubham.
Neetu, so like before going to show the animation, like how this animation looks like, some of the teachers were sharing like how can they make the same thing using the smartphone, and also what were the softwares for smartphone. I would like to share that the same thing, like if you can start with the PPT, these are the basics, and this is the same thing can be done on phone also. There are a few apps like WPS or Microsoft Office for mobile, and there you can create PPT. There will be not every features of desktop PPT will be available, but if you can start with the desktop PPT creation, you can then switch to the mobile part, because and the mobile also will be handy. But once you get the overview, like how to create it, you can do the same on the smartphone also. So Neetu, if we have created this animation, how this animation will look like, can you show to our teachers?
Right, Shubham. So once we have finalized our presentation and we have created all the slides, and also we can keep going slide by slide, so that we can keep a track that what kind of animation we have kept, and if you want to add any other information, so we can do that also. So I'll just show that how my presentation will look like. So this is how it will start, because I had kept a background first and then I had created all the other things. So this is how my presentation will start. It will start with an empty background. And if I click on it, you can see that my topic, the topic I have created would fly in on the screen, because I have kept that animation that it should appear like this on the screen. Then on the second click, the character will appear on the screen. And on the third click, I can see that her introduction is there on the screen. So this is how all my slides will look like if I keep this kind of animation and this kind of background and characters in my presentations. So yes, Shubham, so this is how it looks like.
It really looks nice. The teachers can use their lesson and make this interactive PPT. And most of the teachers already answering queries of teachers also, that they have already made using mobile app. And it would not be a problem, but learning the basics like you have shown, I think this is enough to start to make a interactive PPT if the teachers want to do it. And what else Neetu, a teachers can do with the PPT? We can move forward, and what are the possibilities we want to share with our teacher is for example, teachers, we have shared this is a PPT, and we will start with some of the elements we have shown in this PPT is adding background. Like we have added a background of for water cycle, we have added a background of riverside. If you want to teach students about solar system, you can add a picture of solar system for the background. You can use situation, you can create a very animated kind of PPT in the starting, so that it will grab the attention of the students. After adding a background to give a story to your lesson, we can then add images. For characters, we have used images. Siri, we have used images. You can use images of characters. You can because adding images or character will help to make the PPT more interactive so that they will have a dialogue between them and the students will enjoy the presentation. So after adding images, it is not that only you can add the images of character, you can use concept images from textbook also and put into your slides. After that, adding text and shapes, like for the dialogue, Neetu, you have added a box kind of thing for a chat banner kind of thing. You have added a box, and then in that chat box you have written some dialogues. So likewise, teacher can add text and shapes in the slides to make it more interactive. So what else a teacher can do like with a PPT, Neetu?
Right, Shivam. So as you have mentioned about the characters, images and background, we can also add animation, like we have just seen that how we can simply add animations to our basically presentations and to grab the attention of the students. And basically we will be able to make it more interactive for the students, because one by one information will appear on the screen. So that will help us to grab the attention of the students. If we keep a lot of text on the screen from start itself, that might be confusing for the students, because they will not be able to understand that part. So we can keep animation so that one by one the things are coming on screen and the students are getting students' apt attention is there on the presentation. What we can do next is, Shubham, that we can also record our PPT. We can also create convert our PPT into a video. We can basically set a frame and we can add audio to it, and this presentation, this interactive presentation can be converted into a video. So if our teachers basically they don't want to share just a simple case study, but they want to want to make a concept slideshow. They want to make an interactive concept slideshow where they are providing all the information about the concept. So that can also be done. They can create an interactive slideshow, and after creating that slideshow, they can convert this slideshow into a video. So Shubham, I would request you to show that how our teachers can basically convert this PowerPoint into video, and what resources can we use for that?
Yeah, Neetu. So before like going to that, how to record this PPT in a video and make it a own lecture of kind of thing, and can share with the students. Some of the teachers are also asking that how to add videos or audio, or how to make this add audio to the slideshow. So teachers, let's see one of the software which is called FreeCam. So if you go to Google and just type FreeCam, and the links will also be shared in your chat box and description after the training. So this is the FreeCam software. So to download this FreeCam, this is a very useful and open source kind of thing. You don't have to pay for this tool. This is a FreeCam software, and to download it, Neetu, you just have to go to FreeCam, and the first thing you see is the download option. So to download it, you have to enter your email ID. For example, I will provide my email ID here and press download. So after you just click the download will start. And let's see that after installing this app, you can start using it. So I'll be like now showing my whole screen and show that how this apps look like in the desktop. And similar kind of thing like AZ recorder, AZ screen recorder can be used for mobile also. So this I am sharing a bit more information. So let's share the screen and show how to use this. Yeah. So Neetu, is my screen is visible?
Yes, it is
screen. Yeah. So first of all, to record a thing, let's start with the sample PPT. I've opened the sample PPT, and this is the sample PPT looks like. And we'll go step by step process how to record this thing. For example, this is the first picture, and I would making a lecture kind of video. And in the lecture kind of video, I'll be recording this PPT as well as giving my audio, and it would be more interactive. So as I open the slideshow, now I will open the FreeCam software. So I've already installed the FreeCam software. So this is how the FreeCam software looks like. So it is, Neetu, if you can see, it is very easy and very handy, and there are only few options only, and teachers will not be like face challenges to use FreeCam. There are two options, teachers. There is a create option, there is a recent recording. To create new video, you have to click on new recording, or if you have made already made the videos, you can go to recent recordings and browse here. So let's start with the new recording. If I want to create a new recording, I have to create. So once I click on the create video, this kind of thing will appear. So this is, teacher, this is the setting of the screen size, like what portion of the screen you want to record. If you want to record this portion of the screen, you can record. I just want to record the whole PPT. So this is the whole PPT, and I have given the size name also. This is the PPT size I want to record, and here there were the tabs. So if you see, there is a record option. This is a red color dot. This is if you want to start recording. Here is the mic option. If I wanted to add my audio, so the mic is on. If the mic is not on, it will look like this. To unmute it, just click it here, and this is the size option, and these are the basic settings. Just to let's start recording, Neetu. To start recording, I'll be pressing here and giving my audio to this video. The recording will start in 1 second. And yeah, so students, today we'll read about CV's adventure in the jungle science, and which is the class 8, and the chapter is conservation of plants and animal. So teachers, you can see we'll be reading about two characters. One is CV and Uncle Jagan. So in the next, you know that it's a vacation time. CV is sharing that it's a vacation time again. This time I'll be excited as my parents are taking me to meet my adventurous uncle who works in Ranthamb National Park. So teachers, you could see that I am reciting the dialogue so that it would be very interactive for the students to learn. So as well as I go to the next portion, you can add the dialogues once again. For example, for this slide, I can say, CV, can you tell me, Uncle Jagan, the name of the state in which Ranthambore National Park is situated? Then you can add that it's situated in Rajasthan. As we move forward, we can see elephants in that biodiversity park. We can see horses. So these are kind of information you can add to the PPT. And at the end, you can ask students some few questions, like, a student, tell me that, can you tell me what measures could be taken to save our environment? The second question, are only big animals facing extinction? So at the end of the lecture, you can show the answers also, like after the end of the lecture, after like few days, you can share the answer with the students with an audio file. Like I can say, this is the answer to this. So after recording the video, you can just click it here, done. If you see, this is the done option. I just have to click it here, done. And once I click it done, Neetu, you could see my video has been created. And let me play the audio. And yeah,
so students,
Neetu, is it audible, my video?
Jungle science, and which is the, yes, class, sure. It, and the chapter is conservation of plants and animal. So teachers, you can see we'll be reading about two characters. One is CV and Uncle Jagan. So Neetu, you could see that I have recorded this PPT and made it a animated video kind of thing. If teachers will add more animation, it will look more interactive. So after like recording this video, if teachers find out that what else they can do using the FreeCam software. So if you see, this is a FreeCam software. I could edit it here only. If I click the edit option here, I could, if I want to delete the first 5 seconds of this video, these are the few kind of settings I want to show. Just click it here, left click, and drag the portion you want to delete. Like this portion, I want to delete this 15 seconds. So I just click it here, right click, and I could silence this selection, like audio will be not be played, or I want to delete this portion. Let me delete this portion. If my editing has been completed, I could play it here and see the video once again. And after that, there are a few more options here. Like if you want to remove noise, you can click here to remove noise. If you want to fade in, if you want to fade out the audio, you can do here the transition. And after doing the editing part here on FreeCam only, you can just click save and close. And Neetu, this video can be saved in two ways. Like if you want to save as video, you can click the save as video portion and save it here in your computer. Or if you want to upload to YouTube, you just click on upload to YouTube and directly you give the description. You just sign it here in your Google YouTube account and press OK so that the video will be uploaded in your YouTube account and can be shared with the student, and everyone can see your video you have created on a lesson. So these are the few tricks and tips for using FreeCam software and recording the PPT in an interactive way. Yeah, Neetu.
Right, Shubham. So like this, teachers, we can see that how we can basically easily convert our PPT into a video as well. And also, Shubham, I could see that a lot of teachers were asking about that, how they can insert videos and audios into their presentation. So teachers, as I had shown you, that you can go to insert option, and in that insert option, you will get the option to add videos and audios. So there will be two options available, that whether do you want to add directly it from YouTube. If you want to directly add any video from YouTube, you can copy the link from there and insert it in your presentation. And if you want to add any video from your desktop, which is available in your computer, so you can add it from there also. So these two options are available with our teachers, Shubham.
Neetu, I have just opened the PPT only in the screen. The same thing I want to share here. If you want to add the audio here, teacher, you can go to the insert option. In the insert option, there is two options, video and audio. If you want to add video to your presentation, you can go to this video and add online videos here. Or if you want to add videos from your desktop, you can add the video from your desktop also. Same thing with the audio. So, Neetu, you can continue.
Right, Shubham. And teachers, I can see Rajita ji is asking that, can we use FreeCam in mobile? So ma'am, for mobile, you can use AZ Screen Recorder. This application is available on the Google Play Store, and you can easily download that application. And for recording in your mobile phone, you can use AZ Recorder. FreeCam is for now is available for desktop only. So for mobile phone, AZ Screen Recorder is there. And we have on Guruśāla certain modules about FreeCam and AZ Recorder. So you can also visit to Guruśāla to do these modules and know more about it. We'll also share that how you can basically access Guruśāla. Yes, Shubham.
Yeah. Moving forward, Neetu, like we have discussed about how to create content, the strategy and all of this thing. If we want to show our teachers the Guruśāla platform, and there you could show the view, like explore some of the courses and modules on this content creation part, like how to create digital content, use this apps you are talking about, AZ Screen Recorder for mobile or FreeCam app on desktop to record your like make your digital content. So can you show the Guruśāla website? Yeah.
Right, Shubham. So as teachers, we had mentioned that if you want to visit to Guruśāla, you can simply click www.guruśāla.co on your browser or on your Chrome, whichever software you are using. You can access Guruśāla by just typing in www.guruśāla.co. You can also download Guruśāla application. It is available on the Play Store. So if you feel that will be more convenient for you, you can simply download the application and access website from there also. Once we have basically clicked on, we have come to www.guruśāla.co. You can see that options are available to basically
Sorry for interrupting. Can you just zoom out a little bit so that it will be more visible to our teachers?
Right. I hope it is visible now.
It's visible. Clear. Thanks, ma'am.
Right. So we can see that these options are available. Now what we can do, that we can simply sign in or sign up. If you have already signed in on the Guruśāla, you can just log in. So here I will just log in with my Google ID. So I can click on Google and you can see that I'll be logged into the Guruśāla. So here I have, when I log into Guruśāla, I come to this page of my repository. If I want to go to the home page, you can see that a home icon is there, or you can click on Guruśāla logo and you will be redirected to the home page. And similar options are available in the application. You'll be able to see all these options in the application as well. So here you can see that on the first screen, we have these options: course module, content library, online training, staff room, competitions, express yourself. So teachers, we had also mentioned yesterday that we also talked about in detail that how you can access content library and how you can join teacher community. So this we had discussed in yesterday's session. Today we can discuss about the course module. So if I click on the course module, I'll be redirected to this page of course module. So teachers, more than 100 modules are there on the various aspects of teaching, like pedagogy, classroom management, content creation, and online platforms are there. So you can see that on this page, I have these. I can teach my students that how they can learn time management skill. I can teach my students, I can make them more goal oriented. Also, you will be able to learn about role of parents in managing stress of children. So all these modules are available on the platform, and also these are free of cost modules which you can enroll into, and then you can complete these modules. These are self-paced modules. Maximum it will take you around 2 to 3 hours to complete one module and get the whole information about it. So Shubham, since we were talking about the content creation part and we were talking about that what kind of resources are there, so what we can do, teachers, that you have filters available here, so you can use this filter. If you want to simply know about content resource creation, you can filter the content resource creation modules here, and you will see that use of PowerPoint to create case studies, this module is there. Introduction to PowerPoint is there. Video editing, how you can video edit with PowerDirector, this module is there. You can also know about how to use KineMaster. I could see that in comments, a lot of teachers were sharing that they had created videos by using KineMaster. So this module can also be done. How you can basically make digital interactive books from Google Form. So Google Form can be used for providing information as well, not just for taking assessment, but for providing information as well. So you can see these modules are there, which we'll talk about that how you can analyze or engage students by using digital interactive book and Google Form. Like we have just mentioned about the video creation with FreeCam. So you can see this module is also there. You can use FreeCam and create video. And if teachers want to use it on mobile phone, they can use AZ screen recorder. So teachers, you can go through this module, and after going through this module, you will get to know what features are there in AZ screen recorder and how you can use it. And you'll be able to basically see this module and use that platform as well. And similarly, Shubham, a lot of modules are there, role of PPT, pedagogy, digitization of classroom. So here, teachers, you can explore other modules as well, and you can see what kind of content is available, what modules are available. So for now, I would just like to tell you the structure of one module so that we can see that what kind of structure is available and how you can enroll in these modules. So
yeah, Neetu,
Shubham, we would like to go through the module and show it to our teachers.
Yeah, Neetu. So I think like you have shown various modules on content creation also, like AZ Screen Recorder and FreeCam. So like if you could show an example, like what is the structure of a module and how the teacher could enroll into it and complete the module and overall information about a module, if like you can give a example of it.
Right, Shubham. So if I take an example, if I go to this module of understanding Bloom's taxonomy, which basically talks about what is Bloom's taxonomy and how we can basically implement this taxonomy in our daily teaching practice. So if I go to this module, Shubham, here we can see that this module also includes an assessment and acknowledgement certificate. So teachers, whenever you are completing any module or any course on Guruśāla, you will get a certificate of completion from here. And you can see that this option is there for enroll for free. So you can enroll by just clicking on this module. If I just click on this module, so here you can see that I have got some points for enrolling in this module, and now I can start this module. So here we can see that this is a description about the module and what will you learn from this module, what skills are covered in this module, all this information is available there. So before enrolling into any module, you can just go through about the module, and you can see that what all information is there in the module. So this is the module here. You can see understanding Bloom's taxonomy. If I just click on expand all, you will be able to see the structure of module. So the module is divided into a structure of relate, explore, assess, and further reading. So four sections of modules are there. So like Shubham, it's there in our, it happens with our books also that we have a yes. chapter there, and then we have different topics in our chapter, and accordingly assessments are there, fill in the blanks, and a lot of questions are also there. So similarly, our modules have this structure of relate, explore, assess, and further reading, where our teachers can firstly see a relate video. Through this video, they'll be able to see what is the kind of what are the challenges our teachers are facing and what we are going to talk about in the module. After doing this section, after watching this video, so like this, our teachers can click on this and just see the video. So there is this video of 1 minute and 51 seconds. So like this, we can see once our teachers have gone through the video, they will be redirected to the next section. So once I have seen the whole video, I'll be redirected to the next section. And then there is a questionnaire which we can attempt. There are two questions related to the video. Once we have completed this, we can go to the explore section. In explore section, we have a video which gives us brief understanding about understanding Bloom's taxonomy. We'll be able to know more about Bloom's taxonomy and how to implement it. After that, an infographic is there so that we just get a glimpse of Bloom's taxonomy and about, we basically get the summary of the topic which we have discussed in our module. And as all our as we know that once we have got the information about the topic and once we know about the topic, we also need to assess ourselves. We need to know that what we have learned from the from this module. So our teachers can go through this questionnaire. This is basically a self-assessment for teachers. So they can know that what they have learned from the module and whether they want to go back to the module and do certain sections again. So that can be there. So this is a simple questionnaire for our teachers. And if our teachers want to know more about this Bloom's taxonomy, they want to read in depth about the Bloom's taxonomy, they can go to this further reading section where they will get the further reading and glossary. So if there are any words which were difficult for teachers, they can also go through a glossary, and from here they will be able to know more about it. So Shubham, this is a format which we use for our course module, relate, explore, assess, and further reading structure is there for our teachers. So whenever you go through any module, you will go through these four steps. Yes, Shubham.
Yeah, Neetu. So Neetu, like you have shown the structure, how like the teacher will enroll and go through all the section completed and get a certificate. But after like completing this course, how the teachers will find their certificates or and also the information that is it available, all these sections are available on the app also, if you want to give more information on this.
Right, Shubham. So all these sections are available on the application as well. You will be redirected through this same structure of relate, explore, assess, and further reading whenever if you are enrolling through your mobile phone. And once teachers, we have completed any module, you will get your certificate in the My Repository section. So you can go to My Repository, you can click on My Repository, and here you can see whatever courses you have saved or whatever modules you have saved, all information will be there. So I have saved these modules and I have enrolled in these modules. I can see here. If I want to see my certificate, you can click on My Certificate option. And here you can see that these are the modules I have completed and I have got the certificate for these modules. So this kind of repository is there where you will be able to see all your certificate. If you have saved any kind of content, you will be able to see the content library. If you have created any lesson plan, and if you have saved any lesson plan, these lesson plans will be there. The communities you have joined or the webinars you have joined. So all this information can be seen from here. So your repository basically talks about your activities which you have completed on the platform. Yes, Shubham.
Yeah. So after this, like whatever sections you want to show to our teachers, like this is the one of the example of modules, course modules. What else, if you want to give more information on the modules as well as other sections, like if the teachers want to get ready-made content which can be shared to their student, is it available any sections like that, like kind of right. quiz or something?
Right, Shubham. So teachers, yesterday we talked about content library, that from content library you can share content with your students directly. And if you want to assess your students, if you want to basically share some quizzes with them, so you can see that on the left hand side in this orange bar, we can see that quiz for students section is there. So if we click on quiz for students, you will be redirected to a page. So this is a section which is exclusively for the students. So you can, what you can do, you can select the language of the quiz, you can select the class of the quiz, you can select subject and then level and number of question. And after filtering these things, you will be able to see that a lot of quizzes are there. A quiz on omission is there, types of letters is there, reading comprehension is there. We can see a lot of quiz related to English and for other subjects also. We can see that about the forest, about the farmer's story. So a lot of quizzes are there. You can simply click on any quiz which you want to conduct with your students or share with your students. If you click on quiz, then you can see this kind of a screen will appear and a student will get a chance to attempt these quizzes. These are multiple choice questions and a student will be able to see these questions, and once they have attempted these questions, they will also get the score and they will be able to see what are the correct answers and what questions they have attempted incorrectly. So they'll be able to see here correct answers as well. So a lot of quizzes are available in the quiz for student section. Ready-made quizzes are there, so you can directly share these quizzes with your students as well.
Right, like any other information like teachers could show, like if you want to show any other section which can be helpful for our teachers. And also Neetu, you have shown various section like course modules and this quiz for students. If we move forward, what else do you want to share with our teachers for now?
Right. So these are certain sections, Shubham, which our teachers can utilize. And also teachers, there is a section of lesson plans also. So if you want to create any lesson plans or if you want to directly share any lesson plans, so this option is also available. You can see a lot of our teachers have already created their lesson plans on Guruśāla. There is a structure of introduction, delivery and conclusion which we follow for our lesson plans, because generally in our classes also what we do, that we firstly introduce the topic and then we deliver it in detail and then we conclude the topic. So similar kind of structure you will get here. So if you want to go through these lesson plan, you can see that teachers have created lesson plans on various topics like photosynthesis, respiration, noun. They have created a lot of resources from Guruśāla also, and they create their own resources also. So from here you can access lesson plans and you can create lesson plans also. So this is one more section which will be helpful for our teachers, because our teachers create a lot of lesson plans and they curate a lot of content for our students, so they can do it from now. And also Shubham, we can see that on the top of the Guruśāla a banner is there where we can see a lot of information is provided, that we can see that understanding mental well-being, a session is happening on this. So we can see on 31st May the session will happen, so our teachers can directly register from here. If we can see that they can create and use customized lesson plan from Guruśāla. So these banners will keep updating here about what's happening on Guruśāla. So our teachers can go through these banners and they can check these banners, that what new is there on the Guruśāla.
Right.
Also, if our teacher wants to see our previous training, that what type of trainings have we already conducted. So here this option is there of online training. So our teachers can click on online trainings and all the online trainings and webinars will be there. So we have already conducted a lot of webinars, and a lot of webinars are going to happen in the upcoming time as well. So this section talks about all these webinars. So we can see that a capsule was there on interaction with ICT tools. We can see that we have already talked about mental well-being. So a lot of options are there. A lot of sessions are there, which we have already conducted in the past. And there will be more sessions which we'll be conducting in future. So we can see that all the trainings and webinars will be there. So our teachers can switch between training and webinar by just clicking on these two options here. So if I want to see any training, I can see the training. Teachers who could not attend yesterday's training with us, they can also go to this training section and they can see the training, what we did in yesterday's session. So training on remote teaching techniques was there, which happened on day one. So day one is there. Once today's session is completed, then the day two session will also be there in this section. So if our teachers want to go back and see that what we have done in today's training, they'll be able to watch these sessions again from here. So Yeah, so training a training option is also there. Our teachers can go through our online trainings and webinars, which we have conducted till now. So, Shivam, this was about Gurushala. This was a brief about Gurushala. I'm sure our teachers are surely going to explore it more and understand better that what resources are there on the Gurushala and how these resources can help them. Yes, Shivam.
Yeah, Nitu, like, it's great that the teachers can use all this for free and do all these courses, use the content resource using their teaching. And also we would now it is the time to show the best entries of yesterday's competition or task we have given. And it is great that many teachers have participated in the teachers community of Rajana Sirsila and shared good activities. So we'll be now sharing the best entries. I would congratulate to everyone who have participated on that activity, but we'll be sharing the best entries for now. So the best entries are the first will be Devinder Bhukia sir, then Swarjya Lakshmi Ramgiri, Jyoti Apuri, G Tukaram, A Malesham, Rajashekar Vyagam. So these are the like six top entries we have selected. It's not like first, second, third. These all the teachers have given a good effort for this task, and I would congratulate to all the participants and as well as the winners who have shared great ideas on the yesterday task. Yeah, Nitu, if you want to add something to it, and also we have already make a teachers development or engagement plan for our teachers for specific to the Rajanna and Sirsila teachers. So if you want to share more on it and throw light on this topic.
Right, Shubham. Once again, thank you so much teachers for sharing all these entries with us, and we hope that more and more teachers join this group so that they can share their ideas and they can also get more ideas that what our teachers are implementing and how they are implementing certain strategies with their students. So now, if we talk about the teacher development plan, so teachers, this 2-day training was just a start of a new, basically we would say a kind of new relationship with the Telangana teachers, with the Rajanna Sirsila teachers, and from here we'll keep constantly engaging with the you all, so that we can also learn from you, and we can also share certain strategies and our experience with you. So that kind of interaction will keep happening through different competitions, through different events and different activities which we are going to plan for you in the upcoming future. So if I broadly talk about the teacher development plan that we are going to follow in the upcoming months, so there will be a plan which will be shared with you all for a duration of 3 months. For the next 3 months, we'll be constantly engaging with you so that we can basically assist you in your teaching learning process. And if in case you want any help from our side, we can assist you with that. So this will be a teacher development plan for the next 3 months. The objective of the teacher development plan is basically to enhance the overall, we can say, pedagogical skills and online as well as offline, because a lot of teachers were sharing that how they want to know more about the online teaching, they want to know more about the digital content creation things. So we'll be working on these things together so that we can share the material which we have with you, and you can also share your experiences and your suggestions with us so that we can improve Gurushala for all our teachers. So we would be looking forward to your suggestions also so that we can improve what we are doing currently. And if I talk about that, what we need to do in this teacher development plan, so there will be some tasks which will be assigned. So firstly, you can complete certain course modules. Around 12 modules will be allocated to all our teachers. And these modules are around our online pedagogical skills, and we'll also talk about our communication skills, our 21st century skills, and also our content creation skills, because we have already discussed these three themes in yesterday's and today's session. So now going ahead, we'll keep constantly engaging around these three basically themes so that we can look at the overall development of ourselves. And then the next part will be that two assessments will happen within the span of these 3 months so that we can see that these will be obviously a kind of self-assessment for you, so that you can see that what kind of skills have you learned till now and what else do you want to plan for the next upcoming month. We'll keep constantly engaging with you all so that we can work on this plan together. Yes, Shubham.
I guess this 3 months, it will be more than 3 months of engagement, but definitely this specific 3 months will be very much helpful for our teachers to enhance their knowledge on various skills. And moving forward, we are coming at the end of this training, and I would like to share that there will be a certificate of participation shared with you all after you fill the Google form, which will be shared with you in the comment section. You can go to the description, you can find the link, and also will be shared in your groups. Please fill up the Google form, which is the attendance form also, and after that we'll be sharing your certificate of participation on the email ID. And specifically, teachers, please mention your email ID correctly and the name of your correct name, school names, and all the rest information asked in the Google form. And also this attendance form will be shared in the description. If you are using the YouTube or you are viewing this on our website Gurushala platform, at the below button you can see the attendance form. Link will be created, a button will be there of attendance form. You can click it there, and now it will be open after this training. And please fill up this form to mark your attendance. Moving forward, you can be stay tuned for more updates. And Neetu, if you want to explain more about how can they get more information on all this training, webinar, workshop we are doing every day now and then.
Right, Shubham. So as Shubham has just mentioned, that this is just a start, and we'll be basically sharing more information with you in the upcoming time, and we'll be sharing a lot of information about what sessions we are doing and what type of information are we providing to you. So here you can see that for the more online trainings and capsules, and we conduct some samvad with teachers also, where teachers also get this opportunity to directly basically come in contact with the Gurushala team and basically share their opinions also. So teachers, for that, you can stay tuned with the Gurushala. We'll keep sharing information through WhatsApp groups and through banners on our portal as well. So keep looking for more sessions which we are going to conduct in the upcoming future, because this is just a start. And also you can download the Gurushala application. We'll be sharing the link in the chat section also. You can directly go to Play Store and type Gurushala there. You'll be able to download this application, and you can access this from there. I can see, Shubham, that some teachers are asking about that, is there any cost for completing the module and join Gurushala? So teachers, we would like to inform you that this is a free of cost platform. You can join any course, any module, you can share any kind of content with your students free of cost. There is no cost involved. So you can just check the Gurushala, and you can share content from there and work on your capacity development as well. So we would request you to stay tuned with Gurushala for more information. So with this, we would also like to mention, teachers, that if you face any kind of challenges or difficulty in accessing to Gurushala, or maybe any kind of assistance which you want to, regarding your classroom problems or your classroom situation, please do write to us at info@gurushala.co. This is the email ID which you can use to share any kind of information with us, info@gurushala.co. So you can write an email to us, and we'll be happy to assist you and share our thoughts with you. So this is the login email ID which can be utilized in the upcoming future. And once again, Shubham, we would like to thanks to all our teachers of Rajana Sesila who have joined us for yesterday's and today's training. Thank you so much, teachers. And like we have seen your active participation in the session, we hope to see a similar kind of participation in the upcoming future as well, because we'll be conducting and doing a lot of activities together. So we look forward to engaging with you more and doing more such interactive sessions and activities with you all. So once again, thank you so much, teachers, for joining us, and stay tuned with Gurushala and stay connected with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.